A new study, I hate to even have to bring this back up because we talked about it before Thanksgiving, but a new study finds we're excreting lots of BPA from canned foods. More and more evidence suggests it may not be safe to eat canned foods. A new study involved 75 participants, okay? Half of them were asked to eat a 12-ounce bowl of canned vegetable soup at lunch 5 days in a row. After a two-day break, they had the same size serving of fresh vegetable soup for five lunches in a row. The other half of the volunteers did it in reverse order. First, they had the fresh vegetable soup, 2 days off, then the canned vegetable soup. You with me so far, Lewis?
Right.
What do you think happened? Urine samples were connected at several occasions, usually a few hours after the noontime meal. Those who had the canned soup experienced more than a 1,000% increase in their urinary concentrations of BPA compared to when they had the fresh soup. Disturbing.
Yeah.
The study was published this week in the Journal of American Medical Association. It's one of the first attempts to really measure BPA urine levels soon after the consumption of canned foods. It does raise a lot more questions, though, because all of the urine samples were collected at the same day. Researchers can't say how high BPA levels rose or how quickly it was excreted from the body. Plus, it doesn't address really what the long-term effects are of this level of exposure, right? Mm-hmm. 1,000% higher doesn't really tell us what effect will that have.
Right. Doesn't mean it's going to be 1,000% higher continuously for 2 years.
No, and it doesn't mean that it'll have 1,000 times higher negative health effect necessarily anyway.
It also certainly doesn't mean that you will be purging all of the BPA through your urine. I think that's pretty foolish to assume.
Absolutely. And this the remedy some people say is simple, which is just stop buying canned goods and then the food industry will stop putting food into cans or stop putting BPA into plastic linings. It just doesn't work that way. Even if you get a ton of individuals to stop buying canned food, restaurants and places with mass food preparation are not going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
They rely on the price of these canned foods. They're just not going to do it.
Right. A lot of the time, a lot of the foods you're getting at restaurants come in cans, and those cans are this big.
Right.
And, I mean, there's really no alternative when you're ordering them from the distributors.
The incredible part of this also is that there's thousands of different plastics that don't leach BPA into food. How the FDA has allowed using these types of liners inside these cans that do leach BPA is beyond me. But as we know, the FDA, like everything else, can be bought and sold.
Right.
If we look at the bottled water industry, if you actually research that and watch whether it's Blue Gold or... What's the other bottled water movie? I forget the name of it. The one where Dennis Kucinich is featured pretty prominently. You'll see the FDA can be bought just like everything else, and it's really no real safeguard in many cases.
Right. The FDA does almost nothing, unfortunately.
Well, I'm not saying that. Lewis is saying that, but
it's pretty bad.
It can certainly be bought.
It's pretty bad.
Okay, so I don't know what the solution is with BPA. It's disturbing, though.
You're certainly not going to get people to stop buying canned goods. It's too convenient.
No, oftentimes the boycott is not the right. It's just not going to be successful.
It's not effective.